Good evening, Racine Raider fans. This is Racine Raiders Weekly, and I am Evan Witalis, and the host of Racine Raiders Weekly, and one half of the broadcast team for the Racine Raiders, mostly the games played at Historic Horlick Athletic Field. It's a big, big, big weekend for the Racine Raiders, as the Racine Raiders are going after their 10th national title. You saw on the opening banner, 9-time national champion. Well, the Raiders have a chance to make it 10-time national champions on Saturday when they travel to Washington, D.C. to take on the West Sound Rebels out of Tacoma, Washington. In this quick rundown of the Racine Raiders Weekly, I will recap the Raiders' victory over the Syracuse Strong, talk about their journey to get to D.C., and preview this week's matchup against the Rebels. If you are looking to watch the game, you can watch it on the Racine Raiders YouTube page, the live stream, for free. It is a 5 p.m. kickoff here in Racine, 6 p.m. D.C. time. And the Raiders are also holding a viewing party. If you want to watch the game with other Racine Raider fans and family, go to Angry Brothers on Washington Avenue in Racine and check out the Racine Raiders Quest for 10 from Angry Brothers. Should be a great time, should be a great experience, and super pumped and excited for what can transpire on Saturday. But before we get to this Saturday, I got to jump back to last Saturday and talk about what happened with the Raiders and how they got to this setup. The Racine Raiders traveled by train, by bus, by plane, by whatever means necessary to get there. Well, I know bus and cars and plane for sure, but maybe somebody jumped on a train. If there's a Raider player or fan or somebody watching this and he took the train, put it in the comments and let me know. But anyways, the Raiders went out to Syracuse, New York, about 50 players deep, more than the hometown Syracuse Strong, and defeated the Strong 31-8, snapping Syracuse's 16-game winning streak. Syracuse Strong, the defending GDFL national champion, and the Raiders beat them in order to have this opportunity to play for their 10th national championship. The Raider fans are pumped. The Raiders are pumped. The board is pumped. The fans are pumped. Everybody's fired up for this. This is the Raiders' 70th season, and they have 666 career victories, more than a number of NFL football teams in that time span as well. They're taking on, as I mentioned, the West Sound after they won their game 26-24 over the Inglewood Blackhawks. This is the second straight long road trip for the Raiders. And if the Raiders win on Saturday, they will have victories over teams representing 10 different states. If you want to see that awesome graphic, go to the Racine Raiders Facebook page and check it out. Kind of a cool graphic. And the Raiders, they last won the national title in 2014. So back to Saturday, though, the 31-8 victory started off with two first-half touchdown passes, one to Joe Garcia, which was just an electrifying run. Go find the Racine Raiders Twitter or X account, Twitter account, whatever it's called these days, Facebook, Rios, you'll see it. It was a great play by the playmaker, Joe Garcia, Racine Horlick alum. That put him up 7-0. Another touchdown pass to Chris Hicks, Raider alum, with a club on his hand. He catches a touchdown pass, make it 14-0. The Raiders get a big stop late in the first half to close out the first half, to go in the locker room up two scores. And then Corey Dalton joined the Raiders this season, took the opening second half kickoff 90-plus yards to Pater to put the Raiders up 21-0. And the Raiders just kind of went on from there to get up 28-0. The Sounds scored late in the game to make it 28-8. And the Raiders are 24, make it on the board. And the Raiders scored again late in the game to make it 31-8. And the Raiders celebrated the victory. And as I said, they are now going to Washington, D.C. to take on the South, West Sound. The Raiders this season, give you an idea, too, on what had happened. The Raiders had 2 one-score victories over the Motor City Rams, 27-19, and the St. Paul Pioneers, 30-28, to close out the season. Outside of those two, the Raiders have outscored their opponents 268-17. And in the playoffs, the Raiders beat the Tri-City Outlaws 43-0, the Huntsville Rockets 41-10, and then Syracuse. And as I mentioned, they're taking on the West Sound Rebels, who have a pretty talented football team as it is. Jacob Tace is their quarterback. I'm not sure when these stats were last updated, but at the time of the stats on the GDFL website, 847 yards through the air, 10 touchdowns and 6 interceptions. Running game wise, looks, you know, they look more like they like to pass the ball a lot, it looks like. Corey Klingberg is one of their top receivers. At the time of these stats, had 8 catches for 232 for 3 scores. And Thomas Alston, 6 for 114. Again, not sure when these stats were updated. Just giving you some key players who are very involved offensively for the West Sound Rebels. And your Racine Raiders, led by quarterback Andre Locke, who threw for, sorry, my computer's being a pain. Here we go. Threw for over 1,200 yards and 16 touchdowns and 5 interceptions this season. Led by Tom Banco, who had 172 yards on the season, and Howard Triplett, who was not able to play this game, for 190 yards on the ground. Receiving wise, led by Jashawn Foster and Bibby Davis and Joe Garcia, Jordan Payne, Will Norwood, Darrell James, top receivers for the Racine Raiders this season. And let's not forget, of course, Terrence Fitch. And now we have Chris Hicks back in the mix. Defensively, the Raiders led by linebacker Gary Young, who is back with the team this year after taking a few years away from the team. He was on the 2014 team for the Raiders, who last won the championship. Justin Banco is one of the, and Arion Ivey flank him at the outside linebacker position. Then you got Jay Davis, Jordan Donowski, Robert Lewis in the secondary. Nick Bones Jones, one of the defensive linemen who gets after the quarterback quite well. Nico Lemke, rookie Raider. I mentioned Corey Dalton. You also have J.D. Hardy in the secondary. Veteran Torrey Ruffin, Najee Parker, Gage Zeronik in the defensive line position. The Raider and Antonio Dundee, Anton Graham. The Raiders, very tough defense, very good defense. They're a team that likes to get off after the quarterback, force the turnovers, and they take great pride in shutting down opposing offenses. If you are planning to head out to Washington, D.C. to check out on the game, you can get your tickets online. Go to the GDFL website, click on the first article there that tells you how to watch the game and go to the game and whatnot. Click on the online tickets. If you order online, it's $15. If you pay at the gate, it is $20. And you can watch the game on the Racine Raiders web YouTube page. You can watch the web stream there. For the championship game, we're going back to YouTube to check out the game. Don Wadowitz will be on the call as the play-by-play guy in this game. Don, who does a tremendous job bringing you each and every Racine Raider broadcast. He is also going to be joined by Emlyn Thomas as the commentator for this game. So as I mentioned, Racine Raider fans, this is a huge game. Watch it on YouTube. Head on down to Angry Brothers, where we're going to have a 50-50 raffle and other potential prizes you can win, and cheer on your hometown football team as they take on the West Sound Rebels, who also finished the regular the conference part of their season as 8-0. I'm Evan Wittowson, and this will be my final game preview of Racine Raiders Weekly, but I might have a show next week to recap the season as a whole. I should say I plan on having a show next week to recap the season, hopefully talking to you about the Raiders beating the West Sound Rebels. Until next week, I will talk to you later.